Hi guys, welcome to my lab. This is a nasal indicator for aircraft. The needle indicates the aperture of the nasal from 0 to 100%. 0 corresponds to a completely closed nasal, which is the case at full power, for example, and 100% corresponds to a full open nasal, which is the case in idle mode. You have also a knob. We can set an index here from 0 to 100% with a 0.1% increment. You can see by this mechanical indication. So the nameplate of this instrument is here. So the power supply in this direction should be better. So the power supply is 115 volts at 400 Hz. And on the rear of the instrument, we have this typical aircraft connector circular. Let's take it apart and see what is inside. There are four screws on the back of the case and four also on the front. Let's unscrew this thing. So actually the internal circuit was stuck to the cover, so the circuit comes from the rear of the instrument. So we can see that we have on the back of the instrument several circuit boards, and on the front some mechanical stuff. So we can see effectively that we have one synchro resolver here. Actually, yes, so this is for the needle. It's for the needle. And okay, so we have also a DC motor here. So this DC motor permits to set the position of the needle, and this synchro resolver permits to effectively to measure the exact position. And we have a second resolver here. Normally, yes, for this index. So there is a measurement, of course, of this index with this resolver. And we have also this rotary solenoid, probably, yes, it's to indicate if the device is operational. So that's it, and we have three lamps here. They are in parallel to illuminate the indicator. So the circuit boards will be difficult to remove because they are soldered actually with this flex PCB. This is a very interesting technique because it avoids there are some indicators and you have a lot of wires which are soldered by hand, so it is a mess and very difficult to remove. But this is permits to have a clean wiring with a minimum effort, and I think this should be most reliable than classic wires connection. So this flex PCB connects the rear connector, the circular connector at the rear of the instrument to all PCBs. So the first PCB have this part. I think it's a common mode filter, I think. The power supply comes from one pair of terminals. So obviously there is a small power supply board here with a transformer, filtering caps and some diodes, you can see here. Then we have four electronics board with some very accurate resistor here. It seems to be a metal foil resistor, maybe RCK02 or something like that. So we have on this board, I don't know if you can see, but there are something like 10 of these resistors. There are five trimmers here, and a few op-amps and something like that. And for other boards, this is the same. We have some classic op-amps, this one, for example, the 741. And some transistors, passive parts, etc. So it will be difficult to remove the board because I need to desolder all the solderings. And yes, I can remove, can try to remove these plates. Then the PCB will be free. I don't know. Maybe it is possible. We'll try to remove the plate. Okay, so we can see now the different boards. They are more or less separated. So the first one seems to be the power supply board. We have two transistors, TO39 with a dissipator, two filtering caps. And a toroidal transformer. On the back of the board, we have some passive components and some diodes. This board, you can see that we have some. Okay, this is a UA709. This is an op-amp. I have a second one here. And another one. So we have three op-amps in this board, and effectively some very stable resistors. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 14. 14 resistors. And some adjustments here. On the other one, we have also one very stable resistor here, and also the same op-amp, 709. This one is the 741. This one also, LM741, and this one also. So you have standard op-amps here. The next board. Several resistors and also classic op-amp MC1558, a dual op-amp. And this one is also LM741, a 1558, a dual op-amp also, and two transistors. And the last one, we have a relay. And this one, we have a relay and also several op-amps and some transistors. We have also a transistor here. It is a 2N21, oh sorry, 2102. that's it for this board. So what I will try to do, I will try to see the where are going the resolver and the DC motor for the drive of the needle. I will see which board drives this control, and I will try to make a reverse engineering of this board. So I think I will need 1 hour or something like that. I have separated the mechanical part from the electronics, and actually the part I thought was the synchro resolver are just potentiometers. So there is one potentiometer for the index, this is this one, and the second one, it's a dual potentiometer, the second one. One potentiometer goes to one board, and the second one is connected to the rear connector of the instrument to have a read back of the value. The motor, which is here, goes to one board. Actually, it goes to this board, and the potentiometer goes to this board. So I think that these two boards are used for the control loop of this instrument. So first, I just finished the reverse engineering of this little board, so we can see the schematics. So the schematics, I will make a zoom out. Okay, so the schematics has two different parts actually. So this circuit actually drives the relay. You can see on the board. I will show you if I find it. So this is this small relay here. So actually, at the input, you can see what is called the phase detector. Actually, this GFET is used as a switch. So, for example, if the switch is open, this circuit is actually an inverted amplifier with a gain of -1, because the pin 3 is connected to the ground through this resistor. And you have these two identical resistors, and the input is AC coupled. So at the output, you have the same voltage as the input, but with the phase opposite. And when the transistor is closed, that is to say, if you keep 0 volt here, then you will have the input will be connected to the positive input of the op-amp. And as you have 0 volt across the switch, you don't have any current flowing into this resistor. And in this case, it is like if this resistor doesn't exist anymore, and you have just a voltage follower. So depending on the state of the GFET, you have a gain of +1. Actually, you can find this circuit in this Bible. If you work in electronics, you should have this book. It's The Art of Electronics by Horowitz, and you will find this circuit in this page actually. It's the circuit on the top. This circuit. So when the positive input is at the ground, in the design of the instrument, there is a resistor, but it is the same. And when the input is connected to the input, and you have a gain of -1. So it is something. It is not something which is often used, but it is something which is easy to realize to make a synchronous detection. So actually, the output of this amplifier will have an AC signal and a DC signal, and the DC signal will depend on the phase between the input and the reference signal. Actually, if the input is in phase with the reference signal, you will have a positive DC output. If it is in quadrature, you will have a 0 volt. And if the input is in opposite phase relative to this reference, you will have a negative signal. So the AC signal is filtered by this filter. I cannot see the value of the capacitance, but I think that this circuit works at 400 Hz, probably. So the time constant of this and the 10K and the, this capacitor should be high enough that, that the AC, AC signal is filtered. Actually, you have a frequency which is a double, which is normally 800 Hz here. And the DC signal is compared with this comparator. And depending on the sign of the input, it activates or not the relay. So actually, the relay activates or not depending on the phase of the input. So I don't know the purpose of this circuit in the overall design. I will see later. And the second part, so it's totally independent, is the control of the motor. So the motor is controlled using an op-amp. So the input is connected to one pin of the of this connector. There is a push-pull output to have enough current to drive the motor, and there is a series resistance. And there is this strange circuit. Actually, if you calculate the output voltage, and you find that this voltage as output is the voltage across the motor, enfin, this voltage minus this resistance multiplied by the current. And I measure the DC resistance of the motor, it is very close to 30 ohms. So actually, you will get at the output of the amplifier the voltage which is in the motor, but without the series resistance. So I think it helps for the control loop in order to have a better speed control, I think, of the motor. And this feedback goes to the negative input of the op-amp with some gain, etc. But it doesn't matter. So this is the functioning of this board. So next time I will do the same for the other board for this board, and this will be much more difficult because there are a lot of components. And actually, all the boards has three layers. There are not dual layers, but three layers, and you can see by transparency. Maybe so you have an internal layer. It makes the reverse engineering a bit difficult, and as you have a conformal coating on both sides of the PCB, it is a bit complicated. So I think we need to remove maybe some resistors and at least potentiometers to see the tracks below the part. Otherwise, it is complicated. So that's all for today. I will continue next time. Thank you for watching. Bye bye.